in the NYPD for over 30 years.
Why'd you become a cop?
Where I come from, it was either a gun and a badge or a hard hat and a hammer.
Between the eyes.
You like carrying a gun?
There's nothing wrong with a little shooting as long as the right people get shot.
What about the badge?
The badge is nice, as long as it comes with a gun.
I am forced to dismiss all charges of rape and assault.
When you walk outside, watch your back.
Easy.
Order in my court.
Okay, watch your back.
Order!
That's right. You keep smiling.
What do you get this time?
You shot at close range, dropped right here.
Was up on rape charges, but they got tossed out last week. You know him?
Yeah. Yep.
Somebody shot another bad guy.
We gotta find out who's doing this.
Give him a medal.
Lieutenant, how far do you want us to go with this thing?
Maybe you figure out who did it. Try to put him in jail.
Sounds like fun. Okay, I'm the killer. I show up at your door. And for some reason, you open your door for me.
Who am I?
Someone I know.
But I more than know them. I know everything about them.
These guys are all scumbags. You're staking them out.
Anyone gonna say it?
What?
That's right, it's a cop.
Where do you come off saying it's a cop?
We got a predicament.
I never even heard about a cop serial killer.
That is who I'd like to meet.
These bodies are drifting in your direction.
Drifting or being pushed?
If you don't back him, you will regret it. Please allow me to introduce myself. He's gonna kill again. You know it, and I know it. Pleased to meet you.
Whatever happens,
I'm not taking you down with me.
Who made the decision to enter at that time?
I did.
Whose decision was it?
Mine.
About an inch of daylight between them.
They're like Lennon and McCartney.
You don't become a cop because you want to serve and protect. You do it because you get respect. Most people respect the badge. Everybody respects the gun.
Hi, welcome to your entertainment ticket. I'm Al McGee with Tom and John Delia and Alan Darnay. Well, we're here to talk about and review a movie called Righteous Kill.
Oh, they're too old.
Well, he's referring to Robert De Niro and Al Pacino.
I didn't hear that.
They're in this movie.
Too old? What? I'm sorry.
Headshot.
Huh?
Headshot. Okay.
All right. Well, this movie is about the two New York City detectives. They work to identify a possible connection between a recent murder and, you know, murders going on in the city of New York. But we're going to tell you how we feel about the movie. First, let's start off with Tom. Tom.
Hey, this movie's good. It was filmed in the 80s with Robert De Niro. And it's a very good motion picture that they just shelved for 20 years and they brought out now.
Do you agree with that?
Actually, I didn't really care for the movie that much. I thought that it was a little too contrived and they were setting you up and you sort of knew they were setting you up, but I didn't know for what, I have to admit. But you just sort of knew that and it just kept on pushing it and pushing it. And for me, it was an okay movie.
Okay, I mean, okay, and what? I can spend money and go see it or wait for a DVD?
Hmm?
Give it to Alan.
Oh, that's Alan's turn.
I'm really sure he liked it. I
okay. Thought it was a run of the.
Okay, let him talk. Let him talk.
Thought it was a.
Predictable.
Thought it was a run of the mill detective film. Mm-hmm. Made a little bit better by Pacino and De Niro.
It was.
Because watching the two of them together was kind of fun.
Mm-hmm.
Although, I don't think that it hit the stratosphere for performance by either one of them. And but the direction was pretty good. I thought John Avnet's direction was really good, and the cinematography was really good. I liked it. I thought it was gritty, and I liked the way it was shot. The storyline was garbage.
Oh, I disagree.
Yeah, I'm sure.
Well, all right.
Okay.
Al's going to give us
Al's opinion
the
now.
The real in.
Here we go.
Well,
he knows.
I don't know what's wrong with these guys, but I really enjoyed this movie. It was very suspenseful, kept me on my edge of the seat. I really enjoyed this, and I didn't know which way, you know, they were going far as as what the who did what in the movie. And I couldn't figure it out until they let me figure it out, you know, the ending. And I was surprised at it. And again, I like the acting. You know, Curtis is in this, 50 Cent is in this, John Leguizamo, and you know,
great cast.
Brian Dennehy. Yeah, great cast.
The girl was Dennehy is very cool.
Yeah. What are you going to say?
Okay, well, actually I was going to say this for Alice's defense. Honestly, I actually thought it was a decent movie. I know I said it should have been brought out 20 years ago. It doesn't mean that it's a bad movie.
No, it was brought out 20 years ago.
Different cast. It probably was, but you know what? This has really been a resurgence of classic archetypes from like movies like Death Race, which was a mindless action movie. I haven't had one of those in a long time. College, mindless teen movie that's just for fun. Now we have a good, decent cop thriller. I mean, really, movie producers are going back and going like this. We need to fill in a category. Oh, look, De Niro and Pacino aren't doing anything. Let's make a cop movie.
We have to point out the fact that this is the first time that Pacino and De Niro have spent any time together, per se, on film. They were in Heat for about 4 minutes in one scene.
Godfather 2.
Godfather 2, they never appeared together.
Not together.
No. But for this whole film, they were together. The fact that De Niro is playing De Niro and Pacino was playing Pacino is one thing. But watching them together was kind of nice. The chemistry between them, I thought, was really good.
But that's why they made this movie.
And you know what?
Well, but why this movie?
I have to say,
why this script? This that bothers me. There's so much better material out there. Why would they pick this particular one?
Maybe there isn't.
Oh, there's always better material.
I think it was Avnet. Avnet got him to do it.
Yeah, I'm sure. He's a good director.
Well, I don't see. He wanted
some focus on big-name stars, and he got two big-name stars. And I think for that, I have to say the acting was good. But again, I thought the plot was a little bit...
Well, listen, nobody's denying the fact that the acting is great. It's the material, the source material, I think, is the problem. You're going to enjoy the movie because you're going to watch it, but... I don't know. It's just an average run-of-the-mill film, and it doesn't, just because the two stars are in it, it does not elevate it to a great film.
I agree.
It is a great film.
Average.
And again, you would really enjoy this movie. And we was talking about Carla Gugino. Right. She also excellent.
Stole the film. She stole the film.
Right. And also, there was another great actress in this movie, Melissa Leo. They gave her such a small part, but it was very effective. But
No.
She was the one where her daughter... Well, you know, I got to tell you. I got to tell you.
That one.
Yeah, that was her.
Oh, that's Melissa Leo. I want to give you my own little trivia. For anybody watching this and has ever tuned on to MTV, has watched a show called Robin Big. Rob Diedrich from that show, he's gotten a lot of fame lately. That's he's in this movie for a very small part in which he skates and then gets his head blown off.
Donnie Wahlberg. Yeah, but also, you know, John, the director, his big claim to fame is 18 Miles and Fried Green Tomatoes. He's really a big producer. I love both those movies.
Here's the thing. Before we go on too long, we should just give them a straight out. I say you rent it. I wouldn't pay the money to see this in theaters.
Go see it in the theater because you will enjoy this with other people and you'll have fun watching this and you'll come out when you go have your hamburger after the theater say, I really enjoyed that.
I say rent it.
I'd say rent it.
Ooh. Well, actually, you know what? I'm going to change mine to see it in theaters because he's right. I did enjoy seeing it with more people.
I'm going to change my opinion too. I say see it in theaters.
Really?
I'll wait and see it on cable.
All right. So.
Well, we say... go see it.
No, they will go see it because it's De Niro and Pacino. So.
Exactly. So, this is your entertainment ticket. Well, you know, we're not saying it's a real bad movie. I'm saying it's a great movie, but, you know, we're on the edge. But I love this movie. All right? Thank you for watching. This is Tom and John and Alan, and I'm Al.